We are talking about disease X today and the priority list of pathogens. How does a bacteria or virus get on this list? And what do countries need to do to keep you safe from these pathogens? Here to talk about it is Dr. Ana Maria Henao Restrepo. Welcome, Ana Maria. Let's talk disease X. Is that a real disease that's circulating right now?
Well, I think the first thing I want to clarify today is that there is no a virus or a bacteria circulating right now that is called disease X and is causing disease. We are preparing for the future, so we are talking about an hypothetical disease. To give a name, the scientists call it disease X, to prepare for the hypothetical virus or bacteria that in the future can cause large outbreaks or epidemics or pandemics. There are many viruses and bacteria that can infect animals, including humans. For a few, we already have vaccines, diagnostics, and therapeutics. We know what are the viruses that we need to be alert to. We know what are the bacteria we need to be alert to, but there are many, thousands of them. So we need to have a simplified way to refer to them without knowing which one will cause the next pandemic, and we call it pathogen X.
So, Ana Maria, talk to us about the WHO priority list for pathogens. Why do we need such a list, and how does a pathogen get on that list?
There are many viruses and bacteria that can infect humans and animals in general. So how do you go about preparing for them? You cannot investigate each of them in clear detail, so you have to have a strategy to deal with it. This is why WHO has invited hundreds of scientists to work with us to try to identify which ones have the pandemic potential, which ones we know now with the information we have today can cause severe disease and outbreaks. We also have a list of the ones who are not causing severe disease and outbreaks now, but that may change in the future, so we have to keep an eye on them. So how do we prepare? So we do four things. First of all, we keep an eye. It means we have systems to monitor how they circulate among humans and animals, if they change, if they improve their ability to infect us and cause disease. Second, we have to conduct research to understand how they infect us, how our immune system protects when they infect us. That's critical because it leads to the third step, that is developing in advance vaccines, diagnostics, and therapeutics that can potentially help us reduce the risk of being sick, reduce the risk of having severe disease, and reduce the risk of transmission if they cause an outbreak. Also, we work very much on how to produce these vaccines and these diagnostics and these therapeutics when we develop them, how we ensure that we produce enough of them, use the technology to produce large amounts, how do we evaluate them to ensure they are safe and they are indeed effective against the disease and the severe outcomes that we want to protect people from. And finally, having this list also helps us to focus our collective efforts. You see, we share information, scientists talk to each other, we identify what we know and what is missing, and that way we maximize the capacity we have today to conduct research. In the end, what everybody wants to do and what the scientist wants to do is to help governments to be prepared. So if there is a new pathogen like we have with COVID emerging, that we are better prepared, that there are less people who get sick, less suffering, less economic damage, less problems for the society.
Ana Maria, talk to us about the research and development that countries need to do now to prepare for a future pandemic caused by an unknown disease X.
There are several things that countries can do. From the research perspective, it's important to keep an eye out, to monitor which viruses and bacteria are circulating in their populations, in their country. That's critical. The second thing is to characterize those viruses and bacteria, how they transmit, how they infect the people, how they cause disease. The third point is contribute to your local, regional, and global efforts to develop vaccines, therapeutics, and diagnostics. And the last point is work together to ensure the researchers have the tools, the financial resources, the support to evaluate those products so that we ensure they are safe and they have the desirable effect in reducing infection and disease. And finally, collaboration and coordination is important. Collaboration helps us achieve our goal of getting vaccines, diagnostics and therapeutics to be prepared for the pathogen X or for the next pandemic, whatever causes it.
Thank you, Anna Maria. That was Science in 5 today. Until next time then, stay safe, stay healthy, and stick with science.